Hi, I'm Malika Bilal, and you're in the stream. Today, Sudanese singing sensation El Balabel is here, and they're gearing up for their first ever world tour. Digital producer and my co-host Omar Badar is here. He's looking out for all of your live feedback. I've seen it already coming in, and he's hanging out with some big fans, right, Omar?
I am, and you know, I had no idea how big El Balabel were until I saw some of the feedback that we actually got online. So we have Hind Mekki over here who says, El Balabel are on AJ Stream tomorrow. This is must-watch TV for my whole family. And then we put out a question about what people's favorite bands are out of Sudan, and we have Sally over here who says El Balabel is number one, followed by Nada Al Qalaha. So we can see that we have a lot of fans at home, and if you're not familiar with them yet, you're definitely in for a treat, and you can join this conversation using the hashtag that you see at the bottom of the screen right now, AJ Stream.
My name is Madani, the drama queen, singer, rapper, drama, all around boss lady, and I am in the stream.
Whatever you do, do not call El Balabel the Sudanese Supreme. Because they're quick to tell you, honey, we're better than the Supremes. It's easy to see why the comparison is often made. Like the American Motown group El Balabel, or the Nightingales, is made up of three vibrant and soulful singers with matching dresses. But the similarities stop there. These sisters are unofficial ambassadors for the women of Sudan to the world. Their music and their very presence on stage in Sudan is revolutionary. Well, here to discuss their music and the impact it's had on Sudan and the world, Amel and Hadia Talsam, two of the band's members. And joining via Skype in Washington, D.C., Miaz Abdelaziz, a fan of El Balabel, Ola Diab, a Sudanese blogger and also a fan, and Hajar Osman, a student and another big fan of El Balabel. Welcome to the stream, everyone. So, Hadia and Amel, of course, I'm starting with you. Set the scene for us. It's 1971. We're in Umm Darman, Sudan, in your home. And a family friend comes over, and he asks to speak to your father about what? Tell us what happened. Tell us that story.
You don't want us to say hi to the audience and Ramadan Kareem.
Ramadan Kareem, thank you for being here. You all are in for a treat because our two guests are going to sing for you. And as they mentioned, Ramadan Kareem, it's the fasting month of Ramadan. So we appreciate you coming and joining us. So tell us what you want to tell us.
Okay, and go ahead. Be my guest. Can you repeat that question again?
You're setting the scene for us. You're taking us way back to 1971. Not that far. Not that way, way back. And you're telling us how you got started.
We started with, there is a very famous composer in Sudan. His name is Bashir Abbas. And he was looking for voices. He played lute. And he wanted us to share with him. So he came to our house. And we just went with him for once. We didn't imagine that it's going to last forever. So, and after that, the people, they started making the comment that these are beautiful voices. So we started with him. And then the second song, the first song, I mean. And then after that, they started to look for a name for El Balabel. So the writer, Ali Mack, he is the one who gave us El Balabel, the name. And after that, we started our journey in the early 1971.
That's amazing.
But my sister, they started before us. We are seven sisters and three brothers.
Wow.
Yeah. So the elder sisters, they started with the national folk dance, the Sudanese, the Nubian folk dance, representing the Nubian folk dance. Mm-hmm. And they are the one who we can say, paved the way for us.
Right.
And we came after that.
So was it difficult for your parents to say yes, even for your older sister who you know, paved the way with folk dance? Or was this something they said, sure, you guys can do it, no problem?
Yeah.
You know, the society was very conservative at that time. And in general, a female artist wouldn't be accepted at that time, or not respected, actually. Mm-hmm. That's why it is called, my father and mom, they are considered like being so brave to let seven daughters dancing in the Sudanese national troupe, and again, three of them singing while dancing. So that was, and even acting on theater. So that was really a very brave move from dad and mom and the family.
And of course, you said three. Your other sister, Hayat, she's in Sudan. Yeah. Maybe she'll be watching today's program. Yeah, sure. She couldn't join us, but she's still part of this group, correct?
Yeah,
right.
For sure.
You know, specifically on what you were just talking about the difficulty of being a woman in Sudan and being a public performer, we have people who are commenting about this online, like Fatma, who says, as Sudanese artists, the very thing that you have to deal with in the society, abusing the idea of woman interaction, follows up to ask, so how could they overcome this in order to reach their ambitions? Emma, you want to talk a little bit about that difficulty and what you did?
My dad, we are actually from a Nubian tribe. I mean, from northern Sudan. So the Nubian people, according to our civilization, which I always talk about, the Nubian civilization, they are more liberal than Nubian, not like the other part of Sudan. So my dad was a liberal dad, and my mom encouraged us also, supported us, both of them, although we had a lot of, some of the, our relatives, they didn't talk to us after that. We appeared, they didn't talk to my mom and dad for a long, long time.
Is that, what was that? Is that shame? Is that embarrassment?
Yes, of course.
What other people are going
shame
to say?
And embarrassment, yeah. How dare you do that? The society was conservative, not religious-wise, but customs and traditions. Okay. Not like now, when you compare 1970s, and now they are, the difference in, now it is Islamic Front, and religious issues. Mm-hmm. But at that time, it was the traditional customs. The women used only to work as teachers or some nurses. Few as nurses. Mm-hmm. So the jobs or the role of the woman was limited to a certain fields. Mm-hmm. So when you put your daughters in the stage and moving a little bit, not like
the Supreme. You weren't real dancers.
No. Just a little bit. Okay. Oh my God. And Hadia had this kind of raising her eyebrows.
So is that flirting? Was she, you were flirting
with the
audiences?
Everybody was criticizing her. That she's not a bad, she's a bad girl.
Wow.
How dare she do that?
Wow. I don't mean it, but it happens, you know, when I talk like
right,
this.
Right, it's part of your stage
<That's>
presence. Mayaz, I see you nodding there. Do you want to go for it?
Yeah, with all these challenges, did you ever think of stopping and quitting?
Well, I don't think so. Because we believe that you don't quit being an artist unless the art itself quit you. But we're gonna go for it till the very end.
So I know that the conversation is not necessarily political, but there are some things that happen on the ground that people are curious about, the split in Sudan. So we have Selma who says, what did South Sudan independence referendum mean to Al-Balabil, and do you have any concerts coming up for the fans in Juba? And we also have Muhad Kashif here who says, they cross beyond Sudan, they're a Nubian voice that resonates on both sides of the border. Do you guys have any plans to actually visit South Sudan or perform there?
We already did before, okay. Before you know.
Before the separation.
Separation. Before we did, and I think we speak Nubian language. They have their own language, so we're equal now. Mm-hmm. We understand each other more. You know, we are too close. We don't care about political issues. Mm-hmm. But we're going to go there. We're going to go there and sing again and again and again, hopefully.
And you know what, Omar? Whenever I meet anybody from South of Sudan, I don't think he's from another country. Mm-hmm. I still consider him as Sudanese. We don't agree and we don't believe. Till now, I consider all the South Sudan is still Sudanese, just brother and sisters to us. Mm-hmm. And we cannot forget them. They are.
Ola, you're nodding.
Unforgettable.
I have a question. For
I just loved what she said. But what I want to actually ask was go back to the point where they're talking about the challenges as female artists. So, I mean, there were so many female Sudanese bands that were trying to make it, but did not make it as big as Al-Balabil. So my question is, what is your secret to success?
Well, you want to answer? Or you say what you think, and I'll say what
okay.
I think.
Okay, go ahead, Hadia.
Well, I think, you know, the most important thing is to educate yourself. It's not about only having a nice voice. It's not about the lyrics only, not even the music only. It's you as a character. You have to educate yourself, go forward, and you have to have a character. You have to have a good ideology to think well. You see what I mean?
And to choose
and
well.
To read, to have that, you know, to read what people want to say or tell, and to feel them and love what you're doing, you're gonna do it perfect.
I agree with her, but the main thing or the main issue, I think, because we are sisters. Mm. And Hadia first, and then me, and Hayat is the youngest.
Of course, she's longing for saying this, Hadia first.
So she's not the oldest. Hadia
first. She's the eldest.
Anyway. Well, as a middle child, I can relate to that. Go ahead.
So this is one of the things that made us as three sisters. We love each other, and we love, as a family, we are so united. Mm-hmm. Our parents raised us that way. Right. So we love each other. That's why maybe we understand each other. Before she talk, I know exactly what she's going to say.
Yes, wow. We feel each other. And by the way, I want to add one thing.
Sure.
Our sister Nadia, mm-hmm. which is the eldest, she's the one who do the design for our...
Oh, that's amazing. Yeah,
everything,
wow.
Yeah, from day one.
Wow. Jewelry too, or just the outfits? Okay.
Everything. Wow. She's a real artist.
Well, since you're from a big family, you probably know what it feels like when you're talking and someone else is trying to get in. So I heard Hajar there say, I have a question. Hajar, what's your question?
Well, first, I really want to thank the Stream team for this amazing opportunity for us to share our rich, very, very rich musical history. I mean, Al-Balabil are, they have has an impact on all the Sudanese generations. I mean, they greatly influenced all the generations. I mean, me, my parents, my grandparents. So, yeah.
Hajar, I don't want to interrupt you, but I'm interested in how they influenced you.
I mean, you know, being like a very, very well-known female Sudanese band who made it to this point, you know, that's something that we should be proud of. So I take them as a role model for me. I mean, they have done really, really great job for the Sudanese female in the Sudanese society. So that's why I think they are really doing a great job.
Right. What do you say when you hear that?
Yeah, thank you, honey.
You know, what she means is when you believe in something, then you have to go for it regardless. Mm. And this is exactly the message that we're sending. If you believe in yourself, you believe in something, go for it. Do not care about what people are going to say, because one day they're going to accept it, definitely. Mm-hmm. That's why. So I
buy it for you.
In the beginning, did they not accept it? I mean, you talked about people who talked to your family, but greater society, what was that impact?
We were not accepted. You know what? Let me tell you, even when we at school, mm-hmm. okay, if you come like 1 minute late or you didn't do the homework perfectly, then what would the teacher say? Of course, you do not have time. You were on TV, that's why you didn't like this, uh-huh. you know? And even, you know, your friends at school, the classmates, and they were like, there were barriers between us and them mm-hmm. because their parents or their families or neighbors, they tell them don't be a friend with, mm-hmm. yeah. You see what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but still you find the intellectual people,
yes.
the thinkers, the people, some people, they accept you and they encourage you. Not all of them.
Yeah.
But now things are different, you know, the how the society look at the woman. You know, even now the Sudanese woman is not only an artist, she's everywhere. Mm. From politics to mm-hmm. all fields.
You know, there are certain kinds of music that have gotten so popular beyond their original borders. You know, there's rhyme music out of Algeria, you know, Sheb Khaled, Sheb Mami, you know, that music became so popular everywhere. We have some people who are asking about the potential of Nubian music. We have Buckeye Country over here who says, long live the Nubians, don't know what they're saying, but I like it. So there's somebody who doesn't get it, but actually enjoys the tunes that he's hearing. And Selma says, how did Al-Balabil develop and contribute to Nubian music? And does it have the potential to be popular beyond Sudan and Egypt? Mm-hmm. What are your thoughts?
I think so. Yeah, we had like, in 2007, we performed in New York Central Park.
Oh.
And in 2008, we performed in
Detroit
and Chicago. So me and Hadia, we were representing the Nubian side mm-hmm. and the other singers, mm-hmm. our colleagues. We were like 33 musicians and singers. Mm-hmm. So we were trying to show Sudan
the bright side.
The bright side, because everybody's just talking about Darfur and the war and the South and killing and fighting, violation. So we wanted to give the American people or anybody the other side, the bright side of Sudan. Mm-hmm. So we were representing the Nubian, and we started to, at the beginning when we started with the Arabic songs, because this is the language, the main language of the Middle Khartoum language, or all over
Sudan.
I also have another question. I didn't ask my question yet.
She didn't ask her question. We can still hear you. So let's let the answer get finished, and then we'll go to you for your question. Is that okay?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Go ahead, Emma.
So I said we started with Arabic songs, but lately we started to put to sing some other Nubian songs. And when we sing it at the theater, we tell the people, we are gonna sing you an Indian song. Because all of them, they can taste the Indian, in the movies, and they like it even, although they don't understand. So it's the same thing. Mm-hmm. If you want, as he said, he doesn't understand anything,
but he feels it.
Still,
it sounds good, it's
music. The music,
and the language drums, of the world.
The rhythm, yeah.
Hajar, take it away.
So I really want to ask a question about the Sudanese, you know, music. It's not really reachable for everyone, or you can like the Sudanese young artists should do something. What exactly they should do? I mean, to make it expose it more for everyone around the globe, to make it reachable and, you know, accessible for everyone around the globe. So I just want to know their advice for this young Sudanese artist.
Okay. In the past, when we started, and even before we started, there were male singers like Sayyid Khalifa, Muhammad Werdi, and of course you heard about them. In the past, we used to travel a lot, even without invitation. You go and show your music, your songs, and at that time, Sudan had a very, very big and strong influence on Western Africa and Eastern Africa, like Ethiopia, Somalia, and you go there, Chad, Cameroon, Nigeria, and so on. And but nowadays, it's not like that, because the system is different. I don't know. Maybe I know, but I don't want to talk about it. But the media itself also plays a very big role.
A great role, yeah.
And also, you can say the cultural events, exchange. In the past, when we started singing, it was Numeri. Jaafar Numeri was the president. And he was very keen, wherever he goes, to take the Sudanese national group, dancing troupe, and some singers like Sayyid Khalifa, Balabil, and this stuff, and from sports and this stuff. And then we go, wherever Numeri goes, we go and make shows and, introduce Sudan or represent Sudan, you see? That's why, and even in Sudan at that time, very, very, very famous singers, whether they're Arab or African or even American. Do you know that Jimmy Cliff came to Sudan?
But do you know, Hajar, this is what I say all the time, the diverse of the of Sudan. We have a lot of ethnic groups, different reason. Different languages,
multicultural.
So I'm sure that if we find a way to introduce our music or to show it to the to other part of the world, they are gonna like it. And especially, different reasons. And you know that well, the South and the West and the North and all of them.
It's different beautiful languages, different flavor.
It makes
you know, and move. I know that's true, just because our audience that is tweeting us, they are not all from Sudan, and they're telling us, their love and admiration. I want to share just a couple of tweets of people. These are floating around the internet. People who followed your 45-plus year career. This is someone who includes a picture. You can see it on the screen there, a throwback there. Al Balabel in their younger years. Another person, this is Abel, who says the difference in 45 years of performance, there's a young
we're
picture.
We're still young. We still look
you
young.
You definitely still are.
So I
want to share that love with you. You disbanded, and then you came back. Why did you decide to reunite, basically?
Okay, as I told you, we started, me and Hadia, we had a performance in New York and Chicago and Detroit. Mm-hmm. After that, Hadia's husband, he always encouraged us to, God bless his soul. Mm-hmm. Always he was encouraging, he was asking for, why don't you guys go back?
Continue together.
So he was one of the most important, in the family. Beside the friends, other friends, were all the time trying to encourage us and telling us, go back, go with Hayat, try it. And we were scared at the
You were
the,
scared, not me.
After 20 years, Malika, this is very hard. You are going to be frightened.
Risking. Yeah,
it's a risk.
Of course.
After getting old and you go back again.
You are getting old, not me.
People, the last memory, the people that they remember you when you were 27,
right. Completely
28.
Completely different picture in their minds, right, of course.
So we went back and thank God it was.
Thank God indeed, because you will see why in just a minute. So we've got a few more minutes before the show is over, but that's just enough time to hear the Nightingales or Al Balabal sing. So we're going to tell the ladies to head over to the stage where they will get prepared to sing a song for you. I want to bring in Omar with our community to give the final word from what you guys at home are thinking, and then you'll hear from Al Balabal in a second.
That's right. I'll leave you some thought for people who are familiar with them. We have Gamta over here who says, I often enjoy listening to their song Meshena, among other songs. We have John over here who sees some influences that are interesting. He says, they have a slight echo of Celtic music with the accordions and strings, or perhaps Celtic has an echo of Sudan. Either way, sweet. And then we have Ark over here who says, there is a uniqueness about them that is just so touching.
Thank you, Omar, and of course, thanks to our community for giving us your feedback. So without further ado, of course, you can get more on this conversation. It's going to continue in the post show at stream.aljazeera.com. But as promised, the first, an AJ stream first, with Al Balabal on the AJ stream stage. And of course, they are joined by keyboardist Mahir.
Mahir Hassan.
But you have actually another name that you like to. Taj
Asir.
Taj Asir. It's yes. Beautiful. Look it up. Take it away, ladies.
Okay.
Get ready. We're going to give a Nubian song, okay?
Okay.
Or Indian.
Oh,
you for that. That was beautiful.
This is our costume.
This, that their sister designed.
The Nubian.
Can you get a shot of that? Steady
this is a Nubian.
Come up to you.
Typical Nubian.
What is it called? What's
Jarjar.
The name of it?
Jarjar.
Jarjar.
Okay. Jarjar, because it's...
About. So we're in the post show now. Welcome back. This is the post show, and we are joined by Hadia and Amal Talsam, who are singing from Balabel. And you just sing a song. You said it was a Nubian song. Tell us what it was about.
Love, of course.
Of course, but of course. Yeah. Love of who, of what? Give us a little bit of a translation there.
That love is not shame or and dolgile eba igil torjola jennagiran jagi.
This is a reality. You have nothing to do. I mean, you don't mean to love someone, mm-hmm. but it happens that way.
Yeah.
So you have nothing to do with that.
Right.
You and can't.
Yeah. And he's talking to his lover. You are irbelsam. I mean, you are just like
you
a cure. You cure me.
Mm-hmm.
Say it in so I can translate.
See?
My Shafi, Odafikon, anybody who gets sick, you cure him.
Oh, that's beautiful.
And then another, the last is
Nubian.
You are a Nubian lady, a beautiful lady, just like
I can
gold.
Tell. Just
yeah. I feel like they're talking about your, me here.
Yeah.
That was beautiful. Do you think that as part of your point, and singing in Nubian to help a resurgence of Nubian culture and to make sure it doesn't kind of, you know, fall away?
Exactly.
Okay.
How did you know that?
I'm psychic.
Exactly, that's what.
So we're gonna get you to play one more song, but before we do, I just wanna let our audience know. So while Al Balabel were singing their song, we have three people who are on Skype, from not in the studio, they're outside the studio, but they were nodding their heads along. They were singing, kind of dancing in their seats. They looked like they really enjoyed it. What were you guys feeling? What were you thinking in those moments?
I loved it. I mean, Balabel is one of the, I mean, Balabel and where they introduced me to the music of Nubia. But I was also thinking of the challenges that faces Nubia at this time with the building of the dams and, you know, all of that. So I would love to hear what they have to say about that and how can they support the cause? Because there's some effort to stop these dams of being built. So I just wanted to ask them how do they feel about that and if how will they support the people of Nubia, their people and our people.
But yes, we are not going to let it happen, inshallah. We are going to fight.
Yes,
this is no question. We don't agree. Absolutely. 1,000%, not 100%. Mm. We don't agree.
I'll squeeze in one more comment here from community. We have people who are talking about the generational divide that's taking place. So we have Hisham over here who says, compared to nowadays, music that back then to listen to was much more meaningful. And then we have Mint Nubi over here who says, how have Al Balabel found their fans have changed over the years? And were they surprised to see young millennial audience today? Ola, let me toss this to you first. Do you think that there's a difference in the music that you listen to at this point compared to the music that your parents were listening to before?
Yes, definitely. I mean, as I was listening to them perform, I was thinking about the time about when our parents used to, you know, listen to their music, because it's the older generations that know Al Balabel more than the new generations. And we know about them from what our parents told us about them. And it's just changed so much, because the music you hear from that time, the 70s and the 80s, the Sudanese music, I mean, you don't hear today, not much of it. It's more of a, you know, what they call, the Egyptians call the Habibi music. It's pretty much what's going on in Sudan right now with the new generation music. So this is definitely much what we need to be hearing more often.
And Habibi music, I'll translate there, just the baby music, the sweetheart music, that kind of music. Everyone, that kind of got a chuckle out of everyone. Do you want to respond to that, the generational divide in your fans?
You know, even it's not only in Sudan, even in America, even in Europe, the old songs, when you remember,
the 70s and 80s.
Yeah, the even Steve the Wonder, Lionel Richie,
right,
Diana
right.
Rose, mm-hmm. still, the good thing never dies.
It's true.
Yeah. Right. So it lasts forever. So till now, people, they are listening to the same, the old music in America, in Sudan, the same thing. When we went back, the whole 20 years when we were not singing, the new generation is just the singers. They are repeating the old songs for the right. old singers.
Yeah, yeah.
The same thing. Mm-hmm. There is nothing. They are not creative. This generation, I feel bitter about that.
True. Because and of course, there is not, a reason.
There is no any creativity, right. not only in exactly. music and singing, even in other kind of arts. Mm. So I don't know why.
You know
what's
what?
Going
it's,
on,
it's,
guys?
It's about the lifestyle.
Yes.
Right.
In the 70s, late 60s, 70s, 80s, the lifestyle was so different. And everything is connected to another. So I'm pretty sure that these young ladies, or at their age in Sudan, mm-hmm. I say that they don't have a life in Sudan, mm-hmm. honestly. Mm-hmm. Right. Because we used to know different clubs and used to go to you know sports and travel and movies, mm-hmm. theaters, and this
that doesn't happen anymore. It's,
no, because of the technology, the social right. media, they don't need anything
right.
to go out. And am I right or wrong,
but this
guys?
Is boring as well.
Young
you
ladies,
know?
Am I right or
yeah.
wrong?
Yeah, yeah,
you stay in your room yeah. with your computer or cell
the
phone
mobile.
The whole night.
The WhatsApp.
Well, I will say, well, for today only, we're happy that you're on your computer because it means you get to join us here.
Yeah.
But since we are almost running out of time, before we throw to a song, I wanted to say, you know, Hadi and Ahmed had asked me right before I threw to you guys to ask what you thought about the song. You said, I want to know what you think about
yes,
it
yes, what do you think?
I thought Adika. It was beautiful.
Thank you.
It made me want to dance, and if I weren't on television, I would have.
Yeah.
And also, it made me want to learn Nubian.
But I think you are Nubian. When I look at your features.
Yes.
Yeah, you are features. Nubian. Go yeah. and make this test of the DNA, and I'm sure that you are. You blood
DNA
fast.
Test. And
you
if anyone out there
come Hadia. She's going to be number three.
We could be sisters. We could. We
Instead
really
of
could.
Hayat.
Hayat, if you're watching, thank you for letting me join the family. Okay, so since we're almost running out of time, we are going to let the sisters, Al Balabal, close us out. Of course, you can follow this conversation online. Use hashtag AJ Stream. But before we go, we'll get one more song. Do you want to tell us what that song is?
What do you think, Maher? What do you think?
Agul Ansak. Agul Ansak. Sulaft al Fan Khatinana.
So many options. So what's
give
the name?
A part of
Agul
the song.
Agul Ansak.
Okay. Perfect. No,
Arif Inni Ma Bagdar.
Oh,
I said that
Arabic
I'm going to forget you,
song.
But I know
knowing
that
I won't
can't
be able
to forget you.
I love it already.
Yeah. You love it.
All right, here we go.
Unforgettable.
I'm taking it away. Thanks for joining us, Stream Community.
Thank you, Malika. Thank you, Amma. مجدك عليا يطول يزيد شوقي هواك اكتر وعارف اني ما بقدر مجدك عليا يطول يزيد شوقي هواك اكتر الأعماق والقلب
That was beautiful. That was beautiful. Loved that. Thank you so much. So I heard, in my broken Arabic, I heard, I travel in your eyes.
Exactly.
Beautiful lyrics. Yeah, so where does that song come
from?
And ask. It's gorgeous. That's gorgeous. Thank you so much.
And look and search for in the depth,
inside of you.
والقاك عاطفة تتفجر and find you that you are explosive emotions or
yeah
not device emotions.
So what about you now? From now on, you're gonna sing in Arabic.
I will spare our stream community. I will not be singing in Arabic.
You can do it.
I know that it's a skill that Omar has.
Except I don't have the voice. Nobody wants to hear me sing for
really?
Sure.
You have feelings or not?
I have feelings.
That's enough.
And I have Arabic.
That's enough.
Trust me, you don't know. You don't hear my voice.
Thank you so much for joining us.
It was a pleasure. Thank you, and thank you for the young ladies.
Thank you.
Thank
we
you
love
all
you.
For joining us.
All of you.
For
thanks
being online with us. And of course, Maher Taj Assir, thank you for being on keyboard. Okay, without you, we couldn't have this the good music here. Of course. And Amal and Hadia, thank you so much for joining us and being part of the stream.
Thank you.
We'll see you next time.
Thank you, Omar.
Thank you so much.